Hi, have you thought to yourself lately, man, things could not get any more bizarre? Well, do I have just the story for you. Yesterday, a journalist in Manipur was part of a discussion in a Facebook event where they were talking about the new IT rules, which, you know, the whole country is talking about right now. And the next day, a district collector sent him a notice saying, furnish all documents that show that you are complying with the new IT rules or steps will be taken without further notice. And if that wasn't weird enough already, the next day he found a notice pasted on his door saying that the previous notice has been withdrawn with immediate effect. That's so ridiculous, and it must have felt so spooky and intimidating to have the police take such action against you. Like, that journalist must have felt harassed. This has to do with the new IT rules that came into force just last week. For the first time in the history of India, they seek to regulate digital news platforms, like the one where the Manipur journalist works, or say The Wire or The Caravan, or literally thousands of others in India. So now digital news platforms will suffer things like blocking and content removal if they don't comply with government orders that seek to regulate them. This has raised a lot of concerns. So today I want to break down the four biggest ones for you. From now on, if anybody has a problem with what a digital news platform has published, they can go and complain to the platform. But if they're not happy with the platform's response, or if the platform just doesn't reply in the stipulated time, they can go all the way up to the government, or more specifically, a brand new government oversight committee, which will then seek to censor information as deemed necessary. At the end of the day, it's a government body that can decide kya chalega and kya nahi chalega, even if just in specific instances. And that's still major because these specific instances exist in public memory and create norms around what we know can or cannot work. Usually, a better way to go about content removal is via the courts directly to ensure a certain level of fairness. But there are no courts directly involved here. Now, digital news platforms have to comply with a certain code and ensure that they don't publish unlawful content. But the issue is that what is considered unlawful, that criteria of, you know, obscene or provocative or seditious, is so vague that these digital news platforms will start censoring themselves so that, you know, just to make sure that they don't fall into any of them. This could have a really harmful effect on their freedom of speech or even your own right to access information. We don't want to just read diluted truths in the media. The rules and their stringent regulations are applicable to any publisher of news and current affairs content. This includes anything that's new and noteworthy and, you know, revolving around socio-political or economic or cultural affairs. This is applicable to pretty much any entity that publishes such news online, except those that do it for non-commercial purposes. But we have so many questions here, like, will this just apply to large digital news platforms like, you know, The Hindu or The New York Times, or even smaller ones like something you may want to start tomorrow? And like, what's the threshold of users here? Will somebody like Faye D'Souza or Dhruv Rathi come under this? We need some government clarification here, because imagine constantly feeling like you're under the threat of government action just because you want to make a living reporting the news. All new legislations need to be passed in the parliament, unless of course the parliament delegates authority to a certain ministry. Now, the parliament has not delegated authority to the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting to regulate news media under the IT Act, but that's exactly what they're doing. At least according to our understanding, this technically amounts to the executive branch of the government amending a parliamentary legislation without any proper authority, which is not permissible under our own constitution. So many problems, what to do? The thing is that we live in the age of information and regulation is needed. But we have to do it in a better way. For example, we need more deliberative parliamentary processes, and we can also look to other democracies that are facing and tackling similar situations. For example, Ofcom is a regulator in the UK which has been studying and enforcing regulations that seek to prioritize protecting the citizens' rights and ensuring consistent enforcement of regulation. Instead, what we have right now just increases government and political control, which already suffers from some core design problems and illegality. Don't get me wrong, big tech is not exemplary either. In fact, the amount of power it holds is just anti-democratic, and it's gotten away with far too much for too long. But we cannot fix this with more force and illegality. Instead, the need of the hour is independent, autonomous regulatory bodies that are far away from government or political influence. At the crux of the matter, online content, including news content, should be regulated, but it should also be given space to thrive, and it should not be stifled by regressive norms and paranoia. So stay updated with the IT rules, what's going on with them, the nitty-gritties of them, and how they affect your fundamental rights. Please consider donating to the Internet Freedom Foundation so that we can continue doing the work that we do. We're public funded, we're a charity, and we run on donations from people just like you. And we really need your support to keep fighting the good fight.